Ethiopian pottery is a mixture of two styles of pottery. Europeans and the indigenous Ojibwe people who are already in Detroit. The mixture of those two styles is Ethiopian pottery.
Stand next to Jamal.
Now, what is this picture? Native Americans here, indigenous people. White folks. This white woman and her two kids. That's Lady Marie Calice de Cadillac. Her arrival less than a year after her husband founded Fort Pontchartrain du Détroit. She comes months after him and lives inside the fort. Marie Calice de Cadillac. Remember, as I said, they were trading with the French, and they were coming to bring some furs, and one of the Frenchmen's dogs attacked one of the Ojibwe, attacked one of the warriors who were coming in to trade. And one of the Frenchmen, they dog bit him, and he kicked the dog. I mean, that's what you're gonna do. The dog bites, don't kick the dog, and the French soldier killed the Ojibwe warrior for kicking the dog. Of course, that started a war between the Ojibwe and the French. They killed dozens of Ojibwe because of this.
That was French and Indian?
No, this is just a there were numerous breakouts that we don't call wars today. That's really what they were between the French. So, because in a trade relationship, it's always, the Europeans were always trying to get over. So sometimes the Native Americans would get mad. You may have heard of Pontiac's Rebellion. That was one of those time periods when the indigenous people were like, we going all in. And they killed a whole bunch of Europeans, but they lost. Pontiac was not able to defeat the British. In that case, the British wasn't able to defeat them. But he killed a bunch of them.
Not enough.
Wow. And of course, he ended up being killed himself by a fox tribesman. They got him drunk and killed him outside a saloon. February this year.